price consumption curve and elasticity of demand. In this lesson, we shall discuss how the price consumption curve can be used as an effective tool to identify the kinds of elasticity of demand that a good is likely to enjoy. Look at this graph. To begin with, the consumer is facing price line PL1. It represents the prevailing price in the market P2. He is in equilibrium at point E1, where IC1 is tangent to PL1. He consumes M1 units. Let us tabulate our findings in a table. Open two columns, price and quantity. As we are going to use total expenditure to measure elasticity of demand, let us have one more column, total expenditure. We got two values, price P2 and quantity M1. What is total expenditure? The number of units of good Y that have been sacrificed is the total expenditure on good X. It is PN1 units of good Y. I have taken the physical quantity and not the money value of good Y for two reasons. One, to reduce complexity, and two, it will not affect the final result, whether you take money value or physical units to measure the total expenditure. Price falls to P1. The new price line is PL2. The consumer buys M2 units of good X. The total expenditure incurred on good X is PN2 units of good Y. It is time to find the elasticity of demand. For this, we have to do two things. One, examine whether the price and quantity move in the opposite directions. Yes, they are. Price falls and quantity goes up. Both are moving in the opposite directions. They satisfy the law of demand. Two, we have to compare the price movement with the movement of the total expenditure. The price falls from P2 to P1. The total expenditure increases from PN1 to PN2. You must understand PN2 is greater than PN1. As the total expenditure increases with a fall in price, the demand is relatively elastic. A sloping downward price consumption curve tells us that good X is facing relatively elastic demand. See this graph. The price line PL1 represents P2. Price of good X. The consumer buys M1 quantity of good X. After a fall in the price to P1, the price line becomes PL2. The consumer buys M2 units of good X. After a fall in price, the consumer buys more. At P2 price, the consumer spends PN2 on good X. At P1 price, he spends PN1 on good X. PN1 is less than PN2. As the price falls, the consumer spends less on the commodity. So, the demand is relatively inelastic. The upward sloping price consumption curve signifies relatively inelastic demand. Look at this graph. PL1 represents P2 price, a higher price. Consumer buys M1 quantity of good X. The price falls to P1. The new price line is PL2. The consumer buys M2 units of good X. It is tabulated. Okay. Let us see how much total expenditure is incurred on good X at these two prices. The total expenditure in both the cases is PN1. Even after a fall in price, the same expenditure is incurred. If the total expenditure doesn't change with a change in price, then elasticity is unitary. Price consumption curve, which is parallel to x-axis, indicates unitary elastic demand. Thus, from the shapes of the price consumption curve, we can easily identify the kind of elasticity of demand. In our example, we have seen three different shapes of price consumption curve. This need not be the case always. At times, the price consumption curve incorporates all the three shapes within itself. Look at this graph. The price consumption curve slopes downwards. After reaching the minimum, it slopes upward. The falling segment of the price consumption curve represents a certain price range. In this segment, or price range, demand is relatively elastic. The upward sloping price consumption curve represents a different price range. In this range, the elasticity of demand for good X is less than 1. At the minimum point of the price consumption curve, the elasticity is unitary. Thus, the same price consumption curve exhibits different elasticities in different price ranges. Before we conclude, attempt and answer the true or false type question. If the total outlay moves in the same direction as the price moves, the good is said to have unitary elastic demand. If your answer is false, you are right. We shall discuss the derivation of demand curve from price consumption curve.